Hi, I'm Lokesh. I'm a fourth year and I'm at Brasenose College.
Hi, I'm Olivia. I'm a third year and I'm at Pembroke College.
Hi, I'm David. I'm a second year and I'm at Balliol College.
And so as a fourth year, doing physics and philosophy is quite good because there's a lot of flexibility involved. So by the time you're in fourth year, you can decide to do all physics or all philosophy or a mix of both. So in my case, I've decided to do all physics options. So at the moment, I'm doing astrophysics, atmospheric and oceanic physics, and I'm also doing a master's project in astrophysics. And so in terms of a day in the life, I wake up usually quite late, like 9, 10, go to lectures. Obviously this year, all lectures are online, which is kind of annoying, but it's also kind of fun because it means you can watch them at twice the speed or you can watch them whenever you want. It just makes them more convenient. Usually a couple of lectures per day. And then another good thing about fourth year is that obviously from the step up from school to university, there's a big step up in terms of the independence you have. So in the first couple of years, like I'm sure Olivia and David will talk about, you're more in charge of when you work. You know, there's not just a set day between 9 and 5 that you have to like go to school, for example. You kind of, if you want to work at 3 a.m. in the morning, you can work at 3 a.m. in the morning. And that's kind of even more the case in fourth year because the number of kind of classes you have goes down. And it's a lot more kind of independent study as well. And so that's been nice because I could, if I wanted to, I could take like a couple of days off and then just work really hard for the next like 5 days, or I can kind of do a bit every day. And so for me, I wake up, I have a couple of lectures, go for lunch. You can either go for lunch in your college, which is quite, so at Brasenose, you can go to the hall, and you can just, it's like a pay-as-you-go system, about £3 for lunch, it's not that bad. Or you can, you know, there are loads of restaurants, cafes, wherever you want really. And then in the afternoon, I might have a tutorial. So a tutorial is like this kind of small class. It's basically a class, but at university. And so my tutorials have like 5 people and then a tutor kind of explaining whatever topic we're doing. But I only have one of those per week now in fourth year, which is like quite, not that many compared to the other years. And then with the rest of the day, it could either be, again, there's a lot of flexibility. So like each day will be quite different. I could just be working for the rest of the day. I might have, you know, I might have a society on, I could play some sport. Unfortunately nowadays, so I'm a big fan of squash, but squash isn't going ahead because of coronavirus. So I can't really do that. I might go for a run. I might hang out with friends. And yeah, I think so in terms of a day in the life, a couple of lectures in the morning, might have a tutorial, and apart from that, it's kind of whatever you want to do, and that's the benefit of being old, I guess.
So as a third year, my day in the life is quite similar to Lokesh. In the third year, obviously, you also have quite a lot of flexibility. You can either choose to make your degree physics heavy or philosophy heavy. I've chosen to make my philosophy heavy, which means in both Michaelmas term and Hilary term this year, I have one physics and one philosophy module. So that means that my typical day looks like get up. Pre-pandemic, it would usually be a bit earlier, maybe like 8 to get to lectures for 9, but I slipped a bit later. So in the morning, I'll get up, watch matches. It's usually 1 or 2 a day. And then either do some kind of like self-study until lunch, or again, like Lokesh, you have a lot of freedom with your time, so there are also lots of kind of extracurricular talks and societies that you can go to. So for example, in Oxford, there are lots of things related to philosophy physics you can do. So I go to philosophy physics graduate seminar talks, and there's a seminar held department wide for the philosophy physics, which I also go to, and they can sometimes be around lunchtime or in the afternoon. In the afternoon, you'll either have a tutorial, and these tend to be 2 a week this term, this year, although in early years I had maybe 2 or 3 a week. These are small group teachings, with my physics ones being usually around 3 or 4 per group, and my philosophy ones usually around 2. So you kind of get a lot of attention from your tutor, and these can be from around an hour to sometimes 3 hours for the physics ones, and are a really good way to get like a deeper understanding of the material with help from your tutor. If I don't have one of these in the afternoon, I'll either do kind of self-study. Sometimes in one of the libraries, I like to go to the college library or sometimes even the university libraries, which is another great thing about Oxford. You have lots of study spaces available, or sometimes I'll just study in my room. Most afternoons, because I'm part of the cross-country and athletics club, I will do something relating to that. So whether that's a group session at the track or maybe a run with someone else in the club, although that's not happening, not been happening recently with the pandemic. And then in the evening, depending on, I'll usually cook with my friends because we're in self-catering accommodation. And then depending on how much work I have to do, I will either do some work in the evening or maybe go to a talk. My college physics society often holds talks, or, you know, maybe just join my friends for a bit.
Okay, then I can talk a bit about the second year. In second year, I feel like we're much more building up the basics than what you talked about with specializing in third and fourth year, because at the moment we had in Michaelmas term, the first term of the year, a lot of mathematical methods, which we're taught so that we can deal with the physics that's now coming afterwards. And we're also learning the basics in thermophysics and in quantum mechanics after having done classical mechanics in the first year, and a lot more mathematics modules. And then a usual day for me starts at around 6 a.m. because I'm getting up quite early as part of the rowing team at my college. And then I usually go out for some training, either on the river or for a run or for some workouts. And so after that, I can start at 8 or 9 a.m. with lectures as well. We have lectures in both physics and in philosophy. In philosophy, I'm doing the modules philosophy of science, knowledge and reality, and intermediate philosophy of physics. And so I have a mixture of philosophy and physics lectures, mostly 8 to 10 lectures in physics a week and 1 to 2 lectures in philosophy. And so I usually spend my time with that between 9 and 12. And after that, I also cook lunch with my friends because we also live in self-catered accommodation. But many of my friends also get up around that time. So it's not very usual to get up that early. And then in the afternoons, I also have a mixture of self-study and tutorials. So usually I would have a philosophy tutorial every other week, and then every week one physics or even one physics and one mathematics tutorial. And as the others have already said, tutorials are a great opportunity to ask yourself whether you've really understood the topic, to go through it once again and to understand it thoroughly. And then in the evenings, because I start relatively early, I like to end my day around 7 or 8 if I can, and have dinner together with my friends in our accommodation, maybe go for a walk with friends or to societies, because I'm also part of our chapel choir in Baylor and part of the German society at Oxford, which is a great opportunity to go out beyond the college and meet some people from other colleges as well. And one special thing I can note about second year is that this is the one big opportunity you get to do labs. So despite the pandemic, I had 4 labs this term, 1 data analysis lab, which was over Teams, and the other 3 labs were in person at the physics building. And so that is, as usual in second year, the chance to get an insight into practical work, because the course in physics and philosophy is rather theoretical, writing essays and solving problem sets, but this hands-on experience, which I've had during the last term, was also quite valuable, I think.
Did you enjoy labs, David?
I enjoyed labs despite having the mask on for 7 hours and being in the basement. It was all a bit different this year. We didn't have lab partners, but it is fantastic to see the physics which you're talking about theoretically all the time, for example, in quantum mechanics, that you can then see a quantum effect, which you wouldn't usually see in normal life. And understanding that what you try to describe is in the end describing the real world was a fantastic experience.
That's cool. I mean, labs were good. I don't think I'm as enthusiastic as you about them, but that's fair. Also, I just want to say about rowing. Everybody comes, everybody thinks rowing is the best thing ever, but they will suck you in and they will make you wake up at 6 a.m, as David has said. So hear it from here first. If you don't want to wake up at 6 a.m, do not do rowing. Olivia, I just wanted to ask, you know how you said you're doing philosophy heavy? I just wanted to ask, do you think doing physics heavy versus philosophy heavy in third year, does that have like a big implication on your day in the life, or kind of more workload, less workload?
Yeah, I think so. So I guess the first thing in terms of workload is doing physics heavy, you take an extra module than philosophy heavy. So I guess you can't compare how big the modules are themselves, but you know, I think that does add to the workload. And I think that going philosophy heavy also means that you do even more for the study maybe, and maybe have a bit less set time. For example, I think there's slightly fewer set lectures. I think probably the same amount of tutorials, but I guess, yeah, I think the taking one module less and the slight different nature of the topic means that you probably have more self-study time, which I quite like. And also the philosophy module just interests me more. I never actually said what modules I did. The physics modules I'm taking this year are symmetry and relativity and general relativity, and the extra philosophy module that I'm taking is philosophical logic. So they're just what interested me from what I'd done in the first year and second year. For example, we all do some logic in the first year and I really enjoyed that. Yeah, that's kind of what influenced my decision to take to go philosophy heavy.
And we haven't talked yet about first year stuff. So I'll just, if I can cast my mind back to first year, I think day in the life of a first year kind of goes like this, but you can like correct me if you think I'm wrong. So wake up usually quite early, like 8:30, and then 3 or 4 days a week, you'd have lectures from like 9 a.m. till 12 p.m. It's quite a lot of lectures, especially in first year, mainly maths lectures as well. Like I know you're doing physics and philosophy, but like you've got to learn a lot of maths before you can start doing your physics. And then there might be like one or two philosophy lectures per week. And then in terms of tutorials as well, I think I had on average 2 a week, maybe sometimes 3 a week. It depends on the week and what you're doing exactly. And tutorials usually happen in the afternoon around 2 or 3 p.m. for me, but I mean, it kind of depends on your tutor and everybody's availability. Yeah, in terms of lunch again, I think in first year, I ate breakfast and lunch and dinner almost always in college, in hall, just because I thought it was cheap, I thought it was convenient. I lived in college as well, because you do a Brazen Nose in your first year, and for a lot of colleges as well. So I found that really good. And then in the evening, sometimes they have formal dinners, which you might have heard of, and which I thought were going to be really fancy, and what I was kind of scared of, but actually they're not really... at Brazen Nose anyway, I could go like dressed like this, but just putting a gown on top. And it's like it's a 3-course meal for £6. And I found it like a really good experience just to kind of eat fancy food with your friends. And I really like that. And the key thing, I guess, for first year is that there are no labs. So whilst you'll have classes with physicists and obviously with other philosophers as well, the physicists will have labs either every Thursday or Friday, basically throughout the whole of the year, whereas you don't have that. And so instead, I wasn't jealous of them at all, because whilst they were ploughing away in a lab for the whole day, I was in the library reading a philosophy book, planning my essay, and I liked that a lot more.
And talking about philosophy in first year, I'd also add the special experience you would get as a physicist and philosopher, which is the Leibniz-Clark correspondence. So that's the first proper part of philosophy of physics, which you get to do in first year, thinking about space, what it is from great thinkers like Descartes until the modern times today, what people have thought about it, and then making your own thoughts about it. And that was a great experience for me in Trinity term to see the connection between both subjects.
Do you think, so I genuinely believe in first year anyway, throughout the whole course, but especially in first year, a lot of people asked me whether I thought I was doing more work on a day-to-day basis than someone who does physics, whereas I felt that the time that the physicists spent in the labs or doing kind of circuit theory and electromagnetism, kind of that time was perfectly replaced by me doing philosophy. So I didn't really feel like on a day-to-day basis I was doing more work than the physicists. Do you kind of agree with that?
I'm not sure what you guys think, but I always felt that the physicists had more structured time, and we probably had a similar amount of time, but it was maybe a bit more variable. So you'd have weeks where it was a bit quieter, and then suddenly you'd have the same work as a physicist to be due in 1 week, and plus an essay and a logic problem sheet or something. So that might make it seem like you had more work, but if you kind of look at your term ahead and spread it out evenly, I agree that it's probably not more than, if not the same as a physicist. Yeah, and in all of our days of lives, we all mentioned doing some kind of other activity or extracurricular activity most days, like sports. So I think that shows you can manage to have kind of a healthy balance lifestyle while doing physics and philosophy, even if it does take up a lot of your time. It doesn't mean that you can't do anything else.
In general, I feel like if you're organized and you don't leave stuff to the last minute, which is hard, you can like work and also have a lot of time in your spare time to do whatever you want to do. And there are loads of societies out there. I mean, I remember at Freshers' Fair, I came to university really wanting to be able to defend myself. So I signed up to every single self-defense thing there is, like jiu-jitsu, taekwondo, karate. I still get emails from them every week and I never went to a single session. But like there are loads of societies. I mean, there's underwater hockey, there's Harry Potter society, there's like cheese society, there's definitely wine society. And so, I mean, you know, you can't do everything, obviously, but there's definitely going to be something that hopefully appeals to you a lot. And again, like it's important not to overwhelm yourself and do too many things, but at the same time, there should be time to like, you know, do at least a couple of things that you really enjoy. And if that's just hanging out with your friends, that can also be a thing. I mean, there's no pressure to join any society if you don't want to. David was saying as well, his kind of routine is kind of waking up at 6 a.m. and then like going to sleep a bit earlier. And then I know people who wake up at 12 p.m. 2 minutes before the tutorial and go to sleep at 4 a.m. if they want. That's how they work. And then there's no like set structure that you have to do. There's not like this idea of a perfect physical student will wake up at this time and do this and do this activity. I mean, you can make it work however you want to make it work. And I think that's a really good thing.